गुड आफ्टरनून
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
सो द प्रीवियस पीरियड वी लर्न्ड अबाउट हाउ टू फाइंड इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ गिवन फंक्शन यूजिंग इंटीग्रेशन बाय पार्ट्स। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न डेफिनाइट इंटीग्रल्स। ओके, डेफिनाइट इंटीग्रल्स, राइट द हेडिंग डेफिनाइट इंटीग्रल्स। Before learning about definite integrals, we should understand what is the use of definite integral. Why we are finding this definite integrals? Okay, now listen. Suppose we want to find the area under a curve. Okay, area under a curve. Suppose this is a curve. Okay, integration means it is, that itself I told it is summation. Suppose I want to find area under this curve bounded by these two. X is equal to a and x is equal to b. We want to find the area bounded by this curve and the x-axis. Okay, what we will do, we will be dividing this into small strips. We'll be dividing this into small strips. Okay, in science students, they will be learning more about this. In physics, there is a repeated application of this step. Okay, what we will do, we'll be considering each strip as a rectangle. We will be considering each strip as a rectangle. And what we will do, okay, it is same as we will be finding the area here. The same as finding the area. Okay, here it is small x dx. What is meant by dx? Small x. What is the length? Okay, here it is y value. Here it is y. So area will be same as y dx. Area is length into breadth. This is y axis, isn't it? This is the line y axis. So y into dx. Area is length into breadth. Like this, we can find for each piece. And what you can do, we can add up sigma. Sigma is otherwise called here, it is integration. Integral a to b y dx. This is one important application of integrals. Integrals, where it is used to find the area under the curve. Or if suppose two curves intersect, suppose another curve is like this intersecting, what is the area enclosed between two curves? Okay, all these things are the applications of integrals. Okay, we are just going to learn what is meant by definite integral. Just understand what is there. Okay, suppose here y is equal to f of x. Listen, children. No need to learn that much deep what the science students are learning, but you should know. Okay, look at here. It's a definite integral. What is meant by definite integral? Definite integral is the area bounded by the curve. Right out. Definite integral is the area bounded by the curve. Definite integral. Integral a to b. Definite integral. Integral a to b. Okay. So the definite integral underline it, integral a to b f of x dx is the area bounded by the curve y is equal to f of x. The area bounded by the curve y is equal to f of x, and the ordinates x is equal to a and x is equal to b and the x-axis. So definite integral means it is the area bounded by the curve y is equal to f of x and the ordinates x is equal to a and x is equal to b. In 9th standard itself, we are learning ordinates, abscissa, isn't it? X coordinate is otherwise called ordinate, isn't it? Y coordinate is otherwise called abscissa. Okay, only this much you have to learn. Okay, and the method and all, it is explained in detail for them. For you and all, this part is not there. The problem is how to find definite integral. That's what we are going to learn. Okay, write the question. When you do this one, you'll understand this is an easy one. Nothing to worry. You integrate as usual and then apply the limits. You have to apply the limits. Okay, for example, write the question. For example, one, evaluate integral 2 to 3 x square plus 1 into dx. Integral 2 to 3 x square plus 1 into dx. Integrate 2 to 3 x square plus 1 into dx. So look at here. Okay, this is as usual. Okay, how we integrate, the same method only. Now here we have to learn few terms. Listen, children, how we read this integral 2 to 3. Keep your pen down, sit straight. Listen, all of you. How we are learned reading this? How will you read this function? Integral 2 to 3 x square plus 1 into dx. How will you read that? Aparna, try to read this one.
Ma'am, integral a to b f of x into dx.
Integral a to b f of x into dx. Here, this a, we call this as lower limit. A is called the lower limit. B is the upper limit. This is the lower limit. The one we are writing on the top, we call it as upper limit. So it is integral a to b f of x dx. Integral 2 to 3 x square plus 1 into dx. Now listen, how to do this. Now here, Shubham, tell me which is the lower limit here. Which is the lower limit?
2.
2. And which is the upper limit?
3.
Shubham? 3 is the upper limit. Which is the upper limit and which is the lower limit here? In this function, which is the upper limit and which one is the lower limit?
Two
is the lower limit. And 3 is the upper limit. Okay. So now how to integrate? Listen, children. As usual, how we integrate a function, the same method. What is the integral of x square? What is the integral of x square? X cube. Yes. And that is derivative. Integration. What is integral of x square? Integration is the reverse process of differentiation. You add the power by 1 and divide it by c. Plus, what is integral of 1? Dx. What is integral of 1?
Yes.
X. Within the limits. Now we have integrated. So I am writing this within the square brackets. Within the limits 2 to 3. Okay, first you integrate. After integrating, what you are doing here? Write it within the square brackets. Within the limits 2 to 3. Then, upper limit minus lower limit. Then what's the next step? Upper limit minus lower limit. In the place of x, you substitute upper limit. When you apply the upper limit, it is 3 cubed by 3 plus 3. Upper limit minus lower limit. In the place of x, you put lower limit. So 2 cubed by 3 plus 2. Upper limit minus lower limit. 3 cubed by 3 plus 3 minus 2 cubed by 3 plus 2. What is 3 cubed? 27 by 3 plus 3 minus 8 by 3 minus 2. 27 by 3 plus 3 minus 8 by 3 minus 2. Now simplify this. To cancel this, this is 9, isn't it? 9 plus 3 minus 2, which is same as 10 minus 8 by 3. That is 30 minus 8 by 3, which is 22 by 3. So look at this final answer. You will be getting a constant value there. It is independent of x. What is meant by independent of x? No x term is there, isn't it? Independent means it is not x term is there. You will be getting a constant value only, you will get. So definite integral means what you are doing, it takes only those values between 2 to 3. Okay, then what we are doing, as usual, you integrate, then substitute the values of x, upper limit minus lower limit. First you substitute upper limit minus, then you substitute the lower limits. Okay, is it okay? Is it okay, Anand? Okay, now let's do the next one. Write the next one. Evaluate integral minus 1 to 1 x cube plus 3x plus 1 into dx. X cube plus 3x plus 1 into dx. How to do this? X cube plus 3x plus 1 into dx. So what is the method? You integrate. First you integrate. What is integral of x cube? Integral of x cube is?
3x square.
That is derivative,
Shubham. X raised to 4 by 4.
Okay. X raised to 4 by 4. See, in the beginning itself, if you write the derivative, everything will go wrong. Okay. Plus 3 into, what is integral of x? X integration x square by 2 plus what is integral of 1 x within the limits minus 1 to 1 within the limits minus 1 to 1. Now apply the limits, upper limit minus lower limits, upper limit minus lower limits. Okay, I'm going to substitute the upper limit. Upper limit is here, 1. The place of x, you substitute the upper limit. So 1 raised to 4 by 4 plus 3 into 1 square by 2 plus 1 minus of lower limit, if you substitute, minus 1 whole raised to 4 by 4 plus 3 into minus 1 the whole square by 2 plus minus 1. Okay. Upper limit minus, here we should write the bracket. Minus is common for the whole thing. That's what we are writing the bracket. If you are not writing the bracket, everything will go wrong. Because you will put minus for only the first term. Here minus is for all the terms. So write it within the brackets. So this is same as. What is 1 raised to 4? It is 1, isn't it? Plus 3 by 2 plus 1 minus 1 raised to 4. Minus 1 raised to 4. What do we get?
Positive 1 by 4.
Positive 1 by 4. Okay. Then plus 3 into minus 1 the whole squared. It is again 1 by 2.
The answer is
1. I have to check it. I'll do it and answer. Okay. Because I don't know the answer. I have to check it. Plus 3 by 2. Okay, now we can solve it and we can check. Minus 3 by 2. Aishwarya, is the answer 1?
No, ma'am, 2.
We are also getting 2. Check, Shubham, what is the mistake you did there? What is the mistake? Upper limit minus lower limits.
It will become minus 1 now.
Where?
In the last.
Minus of minus, it will become plus 1. Minus of minus, it will become plus. Okay? Now, I'll give some questions from the text groups. Mm-hmm. write the first one. Integral minus 1 to 1 x plus 1 into dx. Write up. Integral minus 1 to 1 x plus 1 into dx. Integral minus 1 to 1 x plus 1 into dx. Integral minus 1 to 1 plus x into dx. Try this one. Try this and give the answer. What is the answer?
Is it 2? Is it 2?
2. Is it correct, Karthik? Are you getting 2?
Minus 2.
X plus x square by 2, isn't it? When you integrate within the limits minus 1 to 1. Is it correct, Anet? What is the answer you are getting, Anet? Is it 2 or minus 2?
I got 2.
2. Okay. Minus 1 plus minus 1 the whole square by 2. 2. Karthik, you check your answer, Karthik. So answer is 2. Okay, answer is 2. Write the next one. Integral 2 to 3, 1 by x dx. 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 First integrate, then apply the limits. Upper limits minus lower limits. So did you try that one? What is the answer you got? It's a question I gave. Integral. Integral. What is the question? Integral 2 to 3, 1 by x dx. What is the answer? Yes, try, tell me your answer, children. What is integral 2 to 3, 1 by x dx? What is integral of 1 by x? Yes. What is integral of 1 by x?
Log plus c.
It is log x. Whenever we integrate, whenever definite integrals, we integrate definite integrals, no need to put c. Okay, indefinite integrals, we have to add c at the end. But here, no need to put the constants. Okay, so here, integral 2 to 3, 1 by x dx. So what is integral of 1 by x? Log x. Here, we will not try adding c here. Okay, log x within the limits 2 to 3. So you do this. In the place of x, you substitute upper limit minus lower limit. Log 3 minus log 2. And what you have learned last year, what is log a minus log b? What is log a minus log b? Yes. What is log a minus log b?
Log a minus
log b is? And it is log a by b. It is log a by b. So we can write this as log 3 by 2. Log 3 by 2. Okay, now try the next one. Integrate 1 to 2. Integrate 1 to 2. 4x cube, integrate 1 to 2, 4x cube minus 5x square, integrate 1 to 2, 4x cube minus 5x square plus 6x plus 9. Integrate 1 to 2. What is the question? Four x cube minus 5x square plus 6x plus 9. Whole thing into dx. Isn't it? Try this one. So, what is the integral of 4x cube? 4 into, what is the integral of x cube? Karthik, what is the integral of x cube?
X raised to 4 by 4.
Yes, it is x raised to 4 by 4. Minus 5 into, integral of x square. This x cube by 3 plus 6 into, what is integral of x? It is x square by 2 plus 9x within the limits 1 to 2. Within the limits 1 to 2. Now 4 we can cancel. 2 and 6 if you cancel it is 3. So we will get x raised to 4 minus 5x cubed by 3 plus 3x square plus 9x within the limits 1 to 2. Within the limits 1 to 2. Now do the apply upper limits minus lower limits. Upper limits minus lower limits. Okay, apply upper limits minus lower limit. So when you apply upper limits, 2 raised to 4 minus 5 into 2 cubed by 3 plus 3 into 2 square plus 9 into 2 minus of lower limits 1 raised to 4 minus 5 into 1 cubed by 3 plus 3 into 1 square plus 9 into 1 upper limits minus lower limits. Upper limit minus lower limits. That is equivalent to. Simplify this and find out what is the answer. It is 2 raised to 4, isn't it? It is 16 minus 5 into 8 by 3 plus 3 into 4. Plus 9 into 2, which is 18, minus of 1, minus 5 by 3, plus 3, plus 9. This is 16, minus 40 by 3, plus 12, plus 18, minus 1, plus 5 by 3, minus 3, minus 9. And then simplify this. Okay, so what is this? 16 minus 40 by 3 plus 30.
And total answer is 13.
Is it 13? Aishwarya?
I don't know if my answer is correct. I'm getting it 34 by 3.
What about Karthik?
Now I got 64 by 3.
64 by 3. Okay, now let's check the answer. 16 minus 40 by 3 plus 30. I'm adding all these negative numbers. When you add all the negative numbers, you'll get minus 13 plus 5 by 3. Okay, so that is 16 minus 13, what you will get? 16 minus 13, which is 3, isn't it? Minus 40 by 3 plus 5 by 3 means it is negative 35 by 3 plus 30. So it is 33 minus 35 by 3. Is it correct? Anit? So this is same as 99 minus 35 by 3, which is 64 by 3. How many of you get this answer? How many of you got this answer? 64 by 3. Anuj, what is the answer you got? Okay, good. Karthik. Aparna?
Ma'am, I did not did fully, ma'am.
Okay. Finish this one. You do the calculation, do it carefully. Upper limits minus lower limits. Minus is common for all the terms. When you open the brackets, okay, you have to use distributivity. Are you getting this answer, Aparna? Aishwarya?
Yes, ma'am.
Try the next one. Write the next one. Integral 0 to 2. Integral 0 to 2. 6x plus 3 by x square plus 4. Integral 0 to 3. One second, children, this one, okay, sorry, remove this one because you don't have this one. This model is based on inverse trigonometry. It's not there. Okay, I'll change the function right now. Integral 0 to 3, 2x by x square plus 1 into dx. 2x by x square plus 1 into dx. So how to do this? Integral 0 to 3, 2x by x square plus 1 into dx. Okay, what you can do? You take x square plus 1 as t. Okay, I'm going to take x square plus 1 as t. What is the derivative of 2x? X square is 2x into dx will become dt. So the given problem, I will become integral 0 to 3, dt by t. Integral 0 to 3 dt by t. So which is same as log t within the limit 0 to 3. Integral of dt by t is log t. But look at here, children. Here 0 to 3 is the value for x. Okay. 0 and 3 are the values assigned for the variable x. So here we should convert this. Before applying the limit, we should convert this again in terms of x. That is log of, what is t? X square plus 1. Then take the limit. Is it clear? Before applying the limit, you change the variable to x. T is x square plus 1. Now apply the limit. Log of upper limit. Log 3 square plus 1 minus log 0 square plus 1. Upper limit minus lower limits. That is log 10 minus log 1. What is log 1? We have learned all those things last year. What is log 1? Topic. What is log 1? What is log 1? It is 0. Log 1 is 0. Okay, so answer is log 10. It is log 10. Okay. Is it clear? Is it okay? How to find the definite integral? Is it clear? Whenever limits are given, upper limit minus lower limits. Integrate and then apply upper limits minus lower limits. Okay. I'll send the homework questions. Do it and okay, meet you in the next class. Thank you.